Within the state of Oregon, there are 14 volcanoes deemed to be active by the U.S. Geological Survey, which includes the Three Sisters volcano that has an ongoing magmatic intrusion at a depth of 4 miles below the surface. However, despite the wide range of volcanoes in the region, there is a certain type of nearby volcano that exists which the vast majority of people are unaware of, submarine volcanoes. Although not strictly within Oregon's boundaries per se, if you go 290 miles west of the city of Seaside, you will find the large Axial Seamount volcano. Axial Seamount is quite interesting because, for one, we have witnessed it erupt 3 times in recent history. This volcano produced submarine eruptions which sent lava flows onto the seafloor in 1998, 2011, and 2015. And, based on a recent study performed on this volcano, it could very well erupt again in the next year as its edifice has been uplifted by more than 10 feet or 3 meters since its last eruption. So, why does this volcano exist in the first place? The first of 2 factors which explain why this volcano exists is an offshore tectonic plate boundary. Offshore of Northern California, Oregon, Washington State, and sections of British Columbia is the Juan de Fuca plate. This plate is colliding with the North American plate, but is also spreading apart at what is known as a mid-ocean ridge, which is shown in green. Here, the crust is spreading apart, allowing magma from the mantle to erupt onto the surface through a path of least resistance. However, if we zoom in on Axial Seamount, we can see that it isn't strictly on a mid-ocean ridge segment. Rather, it is at its current location due to another cause, as the mid-ocean ridge and adjacent crust simply represent a weak point where magma can easily intrude. Instead, this volcano mainly exists due to a hotspot in the mantle called the Cobb Hotspot. This mantle plume has generated volcanic activity and a chain which gets progressively older to the northwest, as just like the Hawaiian hotspot, the mantle plume is not moving, but the Pacific plate overlying it is. Along with the Bowie hotspot to the north, these 2 hotspots form distinguishable seamount chains. Due to the movement of the various tectonic plates, this hotspot will form a chain of volcanoes on the North American landmass around 9.5 million years from now. The most prominent feature on this volcano is a 5.5-mile long and 1.9-mile wide oval-shaped depression in the ground referred to as a caldera. Yet, despite having about half the area as a massive crater lake caldera which formed in a highly explosive eruption, the caldera at the Axial Seamount formed in a different manner. Instead, it formed when a large effusive eruption occurred on the volcano's flank. This strained the volcano's underlying magma chamber, causing the rock overlying it to collapse downwards and fill the empty space, forming a caldera. In total, the eruption, which likely occurred over the span of several weeks, produced around 3.5 cubic kilometers of lava, which erupted into lobes or balls of material referred to as pillow basalt. However, just like the Kilauea volcano in Hawaii, the present caldera appears to be complex with several stages of collapse as indicated by another caldera wall at higher elevation at the volcano's northwestern summit area. Just how long Axial Seamount has been erupting is unclear, with various estimates suggesting it could have been active as much as several million years ago. Although this volcano has not produced any highly explosive eruptions during this time, it is still good policy for ships to avoid the vicinity of the volcano whenever it erupts, as gas bubbles produced by eruptions can lower the density of water above the volcano, causing ships in a worst-case scenario to sink. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you wish to support this channel, consider becoming a patron on this channel's Patreon page.